Hey guys, welcome to Hash Research 29, I am your researcher. Today, we are looking at best way to take notes through mind maps versus summary sheets. We are looking their benefits, which is best among them. Let's take a look at this video. One of the most important aspects of education and learning is effective note taking. This is a vital tool that helps the user study for exams, write papers and gain an understanding of the subject matter. Two types of note taking, linear and mind mapping, are popular options. Neither are generally considered to be the superior option, rather, a student should choose a method based on personal preference and learning style. Linear note-taking. The linear style of note-taking is usually the most common and, therefore, the most easily recognizable. It's based on an outline that contains headers and subheaders, numbers and letters indicating different sections, underlining of keywords and phrases, and blank spaces to fill in additional details. These notes should follow a somewhat logical order and be organized by topic, or heading. There is no need for full sentences, and you should include your own explanation in addition to that of the reading material or lecture if necessary. Traditional note-taking often feels laborious for us because it bores us mentally while it exhausts us physically. Try writing for 2 hours straight and then see how your writing hand feels, probably not great. Lined paper encourages us to write whole sentences, which is unnecessarily time-consuming and results in pages upon pages of information of which only a small percentage is actually important. Linear notes don't provide a good overview of a topic. We often waste valuable time rereading large chunks of our notes when looking for individual pieces of information. Once a page has been filled, it's extremely hard to add additional information to it. We are forced to squeeze it in between the lines or add it at the bottom of the page with an asterisk. Throughout our academic careers, from first grade through to graduation, we are told what to learn, but the standard curriculum hardly ever includes lessons on how to learn. This is why so many students still spend their study time highlighting passages in textbooks and summarizing chapters, when research has conclusively shown that those study methods are actually the least effective. Similarly, linear notes are still the default format for note-taking for most people, even though it's in many ways one of the least practical formats we could possibly choose. Mind mapping. For more visual learners, note-taking in the form of mind mapping may be more beneficial than the linear method since it's a visual representation of the way a mind works. This is essentially a drawing of your notes, with the main topic in the center of the paper and lines connecting the main points. Each main point should also have additional lines linking subheadings and other points. The use of colors, symbols and other drawings will help by providing a visual connection to your thoughts and facts. The mind map format is a great alternative to linear note-taking and can be used during lectures or presentations, in class, and even while you're reading a text or watching a video. The basic principle of mind mapping is very simple. Instead of lined paper, you start on a blank paper or digital canvas. The subject, for example the topic of the lecture, goes in the center of the canvas, where it's always clearly visible. Instead of writing whole sentences, you note down individual keywords or short phrases, which are connected to the center with lines. Take note better through mind map. It is never too old to learn, so taking note is not only the matter of students in school. During meetings or conferences, taking note using our mind map software can not only record the contents but also the structure and connections. It has been suggested that mind mapping can increase learning, study efficiency up to 15% over traditional note-taking. Benefits of mind map. Mind mapping is a very useful procedure that helps you create plans and strategies. It is a graphical way to present ideas and concepts and is used as a visual thinking tool to structure information to help analyze and create new ideas. People of all age groups can easily use it for various purposes. Young students can also be taught the technique to strategize major school projects and debates. It is easy to learn the technique and once you get the hang of it, it can effectively help solve a host of decision-making issues. Quick to create. It is relatively quick to create your own mind map using paper-based formats or even special software. Both serve a different set of benefits. Paper-based formats will be quick to make, and you can create one at any point in time. On the other hand, using software will facilitate easier modifications. Taking notes in a minute map while reading will help you to gain a deeper understanding of the text, make out connections you may otherwise have missed, better remember what you've read, refresh your memory and look up details quickly. Book summaries. Every good nonfiction book always has a set of core ideas and concepts and it is up to the reader to capture those. If you have tried taking notes as you read, I'm sure you have experienced how often you want to add more notes to another concept on another piece of paper, or you need to reference older notes using arrows, which can lead to very messy notes. Mind maps are ideal for summarizing information, such as that found in books. With branches as your main concepts, you can flesh out concepts and ideas with your scattered notes and structure them for easy comprehension. Mind map benefit to add new information to our long-term memory. We need to process it, comprehend it, connect it with our existing mental frameworks, and review it multiple times. A mind map shows relationships, hierarchies, and connections between individual pieces of information at a glance. Mind maps provide a great overview of a topic because they store all your notes related to that topic on one single page. You can easily attach additional notes, links, and whole files to your map and thus add a whole lot of information to it without diminishing the great overview it provides. Thanks for watching. Please don't forget subscribe our channel. See you next video with interesting topic.